We started this week by motivating linear transformations by looking at a rotation. What I'm now going to show you is how to compute the matrix that represents a rotation. What do we know? We know we want a matrix, and we know that the first column is computed by taking the first unit basis vector and looking at how it's transformed by the linear transformation. Okay, so here we have the first unit basis vector, which we're going to conveniently root at the origin. And if we now rotate that unit basis vector through an angle theta, we get this vector right here. That's the transformed vector. That's r sub theta of 1, 0. From trigonometry, you remember that there is this triangle. We now know that this is of length 1. Therefore, we know that this is sine of theta, and this is cosine of theta. Therefore, we know that this is the same as, let's see, first component is cosine of theta, and the second component is sine of theta. Similarly, if we start with the second unit basis vector and we rotate it through an angle theta, then we end up with this right here. And what do we know now? We know that this is also theta. We know, therefore, that this is sine of theta. And we know that this is cosine of theta. So r sub theta of the second unit basis vector is minus sine theta cosine theta. So what do we have? R theta of x is r theta of x with its components exposed. We know that that can be written as a matrix vector multiply. We know that the first column of that matrix equals the first unit basis vector transformed by rotating through angle theta, and the second column of that matrix equals the second unit basis vector rotated through angle theta. We computed what those were, and therefore we know that if we do this matrix vector multiplication, we get the rotated vector, and that's given right here. And we can also think of that as this linear combination of the rotated unit basis vectors as such. So if we start with an arbitrary vector x now, and we rotate that vector through theta, we know that that's just r theta of that vector. And we now know that that's the same as multiplying the vector by this 2x2 matrix. And when we do that, we get the following result. So the linear transformation that rotates a vector x through an angle theta can be represented by this 2x2 matrix.